Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you how I created this mosaic text reveal in After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Let's get into After Effects. Create a new composition. I'm naming it as main. I'm choosing a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 15 seconds. Grab the text tool and type in your text. I'm typing in my name. Center align the text. Precompose the text layer and name the precompose as text placeholder. Create a new solid layer and name it as top. Choose color of your choice and click OK. With the solid selected, grab the ellipse tool and create a mask like this. Open the mask one, set the mask feather to 1000. Search for noise effect and apply it into the solid layer. Set the amount of noise to 5%. Duplicate the top solid layer and rename it to bottom. Right click on the bottom solid layer and go to transform and choose flip vertical. With the bottom solid layer selected, go to the top and click on the layer menu. In that, choose solid settings and change the color of the solid as you wish. Select the two solid layers and precompose them. Name it as background. Bring down the background layer below the text placeholder. Create another solid and name it as fractal. Choose for fractal noise effect and apply it into the fractal solid layer. Set the noise type to block and the contrast to 250. Go to the transform properties and set the scale to 40. Also set the rotation to 60 degrees. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for evolution, and at the end of the timeline, set the evolution to 3 full rotations. At the 4 second mark, create a keyframe for brightness, and go to the 8 second mark and set the brightness value to minus 250. Go to the start of the timeline and set the brightness value to same minus 250. Search for mosaic effect and apply it into the solid layer. Set the horizontal blocks to 150 and the vertical blocks to around 125. Search for fine edges effect and apply it into the solid layer. Choose the invert option and set the blend with original to 40%. Precompose the solid layer and name it as fractal composition. Search for set matte effect and apply it into the fractal composition. Set the take matte from layer to text placeholder. Set the use for matte to luminance and bring the text placeholder above the fractal composition and turn off its visibility. Also change the blending mode of the fractal composition to screen. Search for CC toner effect and apply it into the fractal composition. Choose color of highlights and midtones as you wish. Duplicate the fractal composition and offset it to 15 frames. Duplicate the fractal composition once more and offset it again to 15 frames. Also change the color of the highlights and midtones in the CC toner effect for these two duplicated fractal compositions. duplicate the text placeholder and turn on the visibility of the duplicated text placeholder composition. Create a new solid layer and name it as text reveal map. Search for fractal noise effect and apply it into the solid layer. Set the noise type to block and the contrast to 250. Go to the transform properties and set the rotation to 60 degrees and the scale to 40. Go to the start of the timeline and create a keyframe for brightness and set the value to -250. Go to the 8 second mark and set the brightness value to +250. Recompose the solid layer and naming it as text reveal map composition. Search for set matte effect and apply it into the text reveal map composition. Set the take matte from layer to duplicated text placeholder and the use for matte to luminance. I'm going to rename the duplicated text placeholder to text placeholder reveal and turn off its visibility. I'm also turning on the visibility of the text reveal map composition and also set the blending mode to screen. Offset the reveal and reveal map compositions to 3 second mark. Select all the layers except the background composition and pre-compose them. I'm naming it as mosaic. Duplicate the mosaic composition and renaming the second composition to reflection. Create a new solid layer and name it as reflection map. Search for fractal noise effect and apply it into the solid layer. Set the contrast value to 300 and pre-compose the solid layer. Turn off the visibility of the reflection map composition and search for combo blur effect. Apply the effect to the reflection composition. Set the maximum blur to 100 and the blur layer to reflection map composition. Make the reflection composition to 3D layer and bring up the position and rotation properties. Set the X rotation to 110 degrees and the Y value of the position to somewhere around 750. Duplicate the reflection layer and delete the compound blur effect. Search for directional blur effect and apply it into the reflection 2 composition. Set the direction to 90 degrees and the blur length to 400. Select all the layers except the background composition and pre-compose them. Now name it as animation and make sure you click on move all attributes. Make the animation composition a 3D layer and at the 3 second mark create a keyframe for position. Go to the start of the timeline and set the Z value of the position to somewhere around -3000. Set the blending mode to screen. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now create a new adjustment layer and name it as vertical glow. Search for glow effect in the effects and presets panel and apply it into the vertical blur adjustment layer. Set the glow threshold to 80% and the glow radius to 200 and also set the glow intensity to 2. Set the glow dimensions to vertical. Press T to bring up the opacity property of the background composition and change it to 50%. Also set the opacity of the adjustment layer to 50%. At around 1 second and 15 frames, create keyframe for the opacity for the animation composition. Go forward about 2 frames and set it to 0. Again go forward to 2 frames and set the value to 100. Repeat the process as long as you want the flicker to happen. Copy these keyframes and paste them wherever you want the flicker to happen. That's it. Let's ramp preview this. That's it. Hope you enjoy this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos. Like, comment and share. and thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching. This is Raudran signing off.